Editing videos with AI is going to save you a ton of time. Today, we're going to be talking real briefly about an extension for Adobe Premier Pro called Autopod. I've got my main man, Raktim, who is one of the graphic video editors here at Mark Savant Media, to share this cool tool with you. Rak, tell me about Autopod and how it's saving you a bunch of time.
So we are inside Adobe Premier Pro right now. What I did was, this is a multi-cam sequence. The first top camera, video 3, is the white side-by-side shot of the guest and the host. This is the guest, video 2. And video 1 is our host.
Yeah, I look good, bro. I look so good.
Thank you. You do anyway, Trace.
Hey, you're the one who makes it happen, dude. I just turn on the lights.
So, and below that, for audio 1, this is Mark Savant's audio, and audio 2 is the guest's audio. Obviously, I went ahead and did some manual tweaking, a little bit. And now, what we do is simply go into Windows, Extensions, and you'll get 3. After you download the Autopod software, you get 3 options here. I selected this one, Multicam Editor, and I get this pop-up. Over here, you get a bunch of options. Number 1, cutting method. Normally for editors, what we do is we go and manually cut. Let's say for a 2 minute video, if you go manually and keep cutting it, it will take more than half an hour to just finish up the initial cut.
And what you mean now, by cutting it is you're manually going in, let's say wherever, like I would stop speaking and David would start speaking, and you'd have to cut it and then zoom in or zoom out based on the...
Yeah. For example, I'll just show you. Let's say over here you are speaking. I'll go here, simply cut it here. After cutting it, what I'll do, I want the first part just to be, let's say, focusing on you. So I delete the other tracks or disable the other tracks. Then this side, the guest is saying something. Let's say over here he finishes it. I'll cut it again. I'll probably disable or delete this part. So the guest is speaking. So end of the day, it starts off this way. So it takes at least half an hour to finish up the entire episode properly.
Especially if it's a longer episode. It also, yeah, you know, the more times you're doing cuts and stuff, the greater the opportunity for error.
Yeah. So what Autopod does is, this gives you this option here. So what I have selected as standard is basically it will delete the videos that the AI thinks it's not required, the video parts. And enable disable is basically it will enable and disable certain tracks, video 1, video 2, and so forth. Later on, if you find that no, I want this part to be there, so you can enable it again. I'll show you in a minute. So we'll select enable disable. Now they say wide angle shot frequency. So for me, it is video 3. This is the wide angle, the one you're looking on the screen right now.
Like a side by side, right?
Side by side. So I've kept it, the frequency should be high. I want that. Then speakers, number of speakers. We, up to 10 speakers it can support. So we've given 2 speakers.
So if I was recording a video in Zoom with, let's say, 5 or 6 people, you could also set Autopod.
Yep.
That's interesting. That's really cool.
However, inside Zoom, you have to specifically have a setting. You have to enable the setting that record individual videos separately and audios. Then it will work better.
Interesting. Okay.
Okay, so we've got 2 speakers, cameras, we've got 3 cameras, wide angle, close up of the guest, close up of the host, these 3. Now, it says delay cuts. Let's say when you're speaking on top of each other, probably 0.01 second or 1 second, you can keep a buffer zone. So I keep it. This is the default setting. I keep it that way. Ignore cuts lesser than 1 second. So I've kept it that way. Now,
so like if I jump in real quick, it'll just ignore that because it becomes too choppy. Interesting. Wow. Exactly. This is really, is someone, I don't do a lot of editing these days, but when I was doing editing, this stuff was a nightmare. It took so much time. This is amazing.
Then it goes on to the speakers for audio. Let's say first track is yours, Mark Savant's audio. So I've made it Mark Savant. Audio 2 is the guest, David. So I've named it that way. Now you have to tag the speakers. When you put in the names over here, it automatically detects things over here. So video one, which is this one. So video one is this. This is Mark Savant, sir. This is Mark Savant. Video two is the guest. So I've given this guest. And video three is the wide angle, which has all the speakers. So I've kept it all speakers. Now, you have to do is grab a probably cup of coffee or something, or have some water. Click on here. Wait for probably a minute at the max. And by the way, this is happening real time.
Yeah, you know, listen, like I said, I don't do all the editing, but when Raktim started showing me this stuff, I said, holy crap, Rock, this is crazy. I'm hitting a record and we need to share this with the world because this is awesome. That's what we're dedicated to here.
By the way, just look at it. It's cutting it in
real time. That's amazing. Look at all those clips. Holy cow, that is nuts. And the tool is doing that essentially automatically. Like if you're a creator and you're not paying attention to this AI stuff, you're in trouble, dude.
It's done.
That is crazy. Can we see the final product?
Yeah, so I'll just close this. In certain videos, you do have to go in manually a little bit, not much. Let's say for this one, you start off with your shot in the middle. Normally, you introduce the guest. After that, we go for the guest shot. So here, the AI has done a little bit of an error. So
yeah, hit play. I want to see it. Hit just a play.
Yeah.
Right. So it's, you know, so this is important because it's creating pattern interrupts automatically.
And let's say we only want your video to be playing for the first probably 30 seconds. So what we do is simply enable your track, right click, enable this, and right click, disable this. So it's continuing with your video only. Now, after that, when the guest comes in, so now, let's see. It's,
you know, but I like the side by side stuff. And you know, this is really interesting because I'm seeing like these big podcasts. I was watching a podcast with Mr. Beast the other day, and this is what they do: they have video of the guest speaking, video of the host speaking, and then the side by side. And it's just moving back and forth. But if you're working on like a 3-hour video, like a Rogan style video, you could edit it in just seconds. I also like, it's still the same audio track, so you could still do all of your audio edits on the single track, right? If you're trying to remove spectral frequencies and increase, decrease.
And also, if you just look into it, when the guest is speaking, your side of the audio, it's you're not speaking anything. However, the AI detects even if you're smiling, you're nodding, you're doing something behind the camera. I'll show you that part. Let's see.
Whoa!
Hold on a second now.
How can you tell that it's detecting a smile? Like what happens when a smile happens or a nod or a laugh or something?
So this is what they do is, let's say you are nodding, you're near the mic. Even if you do a subtle, when you're nodding, subtle sounds come in. Probably when you're smiling, the AI detects that. It's so smart.
Question, you also mentioned to me that there's a social clip creator.
Yep.
So this can also automatically create clips for social media?
Yeah. So I tried doing that. Let's say I'll just show you just a bit of it. I'll just do this. Probably cut it here. By the way, it's just a random thing I'm doing right now. I'll click take these ones. Probably. Normally I take it to a new sequence, but let's say over here, this is the in. And this is the out. This is probably a 5-second clip. So what I'll do is select everything, then go to Windows, Extension, Social Clip Creator. Go here.
So it won't just automatically select. It'll...
You can do that as well. It will not automatically select. It's not video.ai.
Right. So okay.
Normally what happens, we have to do this from a wide angle shot or a horizontal shot to a vertical shot. So it takes time for us to probably zoom in or zoom out and the guest is saying something or the host is saying something. Now, it has different options. Let's say you want a 1920 by 1080. you want a 1080 by 1350 or you want a vertical clip. I've selected these ones, 1080 by 1920, auto reframe. If you want to add a watermark, let's say your logo, you can add that. And then you have to just, while creating the clips, it will ask you to add the watermark. Then let's say you want to add an end page. Let's say you want some animations there or probably follow for more. That's the end page, let's say. So click here. While creating the clips, it will ask you, where is the end page? Then select the end page and offset, as in, when do you want the end page to start off? Let's say just probably 1.3 seconds before the clips ends, the end page should start off.
Super interesting, because like you said, all that like moving and reformatting and moving stuff around, it can be very laborious. I'm not, the social clip creator portion, to me, it's missing the mark a little bit, like, because, I like how video.ai and some of these others can just like rip an entire YouTube video and just make a bunch of clips. You need to sometimes, you need to give it a little bit of TLC. But what's interesting to me is this tech is only going to get better. You need to start adapting to the tech now.
So this is what I got from the AI. Mind you, this is nothing that I've edited on my own. I just cut certain parts, that's it. And it's reframed everything on its own. It's even detected that he's trying to show the book. So it's detected that now we should focus on the book part. So, and again, it goes back to him. So this is what.
Very interesting. And one of the benefits of being an Adobe Premier Pro is it does give you as an expert more ability to customize the clips, but it just saves you a bunch of time in the formatting section. I really like the video.ai clip creator, probably better, because I think it saves more time. It adds transcriptions and stuff automatically. But I got to say, this tech is only getting better. And as a creator, if you're not learning this stuff, you're in big trouble. If you want to learn more about this, if you want to join a team that's on the cutting edge, if you want to secure your future, go to marksavantmedia.com to find out more. Thanks, Rock.
Thanks, Mark.